Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about screening. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Screening for a disease is defined as a search for unrecognized disease or defect by means of rapidly applied tests, examinations or other procedures in apparently healthy individuals. In other words, screening is a strategy used in a population to identify the possible presence of an as yet undiagnosed disease in individuals without signs or symptoms. This picture denotes screening. Now let us see about the principles of screening. These are also known as Wilson's criteria for screening. The condition that is screened should be an important health problem. There should be a treatment for the condition. Facilities for diagnosis and treatment should be available. There should be a latent stage of the disease. There should be a test or examination for the condition. The test should be acceptable to the population. The natural history of the disease should be adequately understood. There should be an agreed policy on whom to treat. The total cost of finding a case should be economically balanced in relation to medical expenditure as a whole. Case finding should be a continuous process, not just a once and for all project. Now let us see about the concept of lead time. This is a very important concept in screening. Now let me explain this figure. This point is the onset of disease. This point is the first possible point of diagnosis. This point denotes the diagnosis of the disease using screening tests. This point denotes the usual time of diagnosis of a disease by clinical methods. The time between the first possible point of diagnosis and the point of diagnosis of a disease by screening tests is called as screening time. The time between the first possible point of diagnosis using screening tests and the point of usual diagnosis of a disease by clinical methods is called as lead time. Outcome A denotes the outcome of the disease without screening. Outcome B denotes the outcome of a disease with screening. A few important points to remember are, there is nothing to be gained in screening for diseases whose onset is quite obvious. This is because the first possible point of diagnosis and the usual time of diagnosis by clinical methods both are very close in these diseases. Detection programs should be restricted to those conditions in which there is considerable time lag between disease onset and the usual time of diagnosis. Lead time is the advantage gained by screening, that is, the period between diagnosis by early detection and diagnosis by other means. The benefits of the program can be given by B minus A. Now let us see about the types of screening. There are three types of screening. They are mass screening, high risk or selective screening, and multiphasic screening. Mass screening is screening of a whole population or a subgroup. For example, all adults. It is offered to all irrespective of the particular risk individual may run of contracting the disease in question. Indiscriminate mass screening is not a useful preventive measure unless it is backed up by suitable treatment that will reduce the duration of illness or alter its final outcome. Now let us see about high risk or selective screening. High risk groups are defined on the basis of epidemiological research. Screening will be most productive if it is applied to high risk groups. For example, screening for cancer cervix in the lower social groups and screening of family members of diabetes patients. Screening can also be done for risk factors like elevated serum cholesterol, because serum cholesterol is amenable, and so preventive measures can be applied before the disease occurs. High risk or selective screening is effective and economical. Now let us see about multiphasic screening. Application of two or more screening tests in combination to a large number of people at one time than to carry out separate screening tests for single diseases is called multiphasic screening. It can include a health questionnaire, clinical examination, and a range of measurements and investigations. It has been found that no benefit is accruing to the population in terms of mortality and morbidity reduction due to multiphasic screening. It has increased the cost of health services without any observable benefits. Now let us see about the uses of screening. There are four uses. They are case detection, control of disease, research purposes, and educational opportunities. Case detection. In this case, it is called as prescriptive screening. People are screened primarily for their own benefit. Presumptive identification of unrecognized disease which does not arise from a patient's request is one of the main uses of screening. Examples for case detection using screening include neonatal screening, bacteriuria in pregnancy, breast cancer, cervical cancer, deafness in children, diabetes mellitus, iron deficiency anemia, phenylketonuria, pulmonary tuberculosis, hemolytic disease of newborn. These diseases can be detected by using screening tests. Control of disease is another use of screening. In this case, it is called as prospective screening. People are examined for the benefit of others. Screening helps in the early diagnosis of diseases, so more effective treatment can be given and it can reduce the spread of infectious disease or mortality from the disease. Example for prospective screening include screening of immigrants for infectious diseases like TB and syphilis to protect the home population. Screening can also be done for research purposes. Screening aids in obtaining more basic knowledge about the natural history of diseases like cancer, hypertension, etc. Screening also provides educational opportunities. Screening provides opportunities for creating public awareness and for educating health professionals. Screening for diabetes can be used as an educational opportunity to create awareness among the public and to educate health professionals. Now let us see about the evaluation of a screening test. Sensitivity. It is the ability of a screening test to identify correctly all those who have the disease, that is true positive. If a test has 90% sensitivity, it means that 90% of the diseased people screened by the test will give a true positive result and the remaining 10% will give a false negative result. Now let us see about specificity. It is defined as the ability of a test to identify correctly those who do not have the disease, that is true negatives. If a screening test has 90% specificity, it means that 90% of the non-diseased persons will give true negative result and the remaining 10% will give a false positive result. Now let us see about positive predictive value. It is the probability that subjects with a positive screening test truly have the disease. Negative predictive value is the probability that subjects with a negative screening test truly don't have the disease. Now let us see about some important formulae. In this tabular column, A means the disease is present and the screening test is positive, that is true positive. B means disease is absent but the screening test is positive, which means false positive. C means disease is present but the test is negative, which means that false negative. D means disease is absent and the screening test is negative, which means that true negative. Sensitivity is equal to A divided by A plus C into 100. Specificity is equal to B divided by B plus D into 100. Positive predictive value is equal to A divided by A plus B into 100. Negative predictive value is equal to D divided by D plus C into 100. If you have any suggestions, Please let me know in the comment section. If you like the video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.